Guys, welcome to my YouTube channel. And in this video, right, so from start to finish, I'm going to show you like this particular image you are seeing on the screen, this product that you are seeing on the screen, how I shot the picture from start to finish, you know, from here down to Photoshop, right? So I don't want to, you know, bore you with so much talks and all. If you are into photography or you are into this industry, you know that AI is really, really taking major part of the industry, so and you cannot be left out. So in this video, so I'll be using this product, right, to show you how I use AI to generate, you know, this prompt that you are seeing. You understand? Trust me, this is not a paid advert. So or disclaimer purposes, right? So I'll be using a continuous light. My suit photo is there, and this product. So and see, let me tell you this, right? If you are shooting for AI, maybe you want to use AI to generate prompts for your picture, so it's advisable that you use a plain backdrop. So stay tuned and go now. Using Canon Arrow 6 and my settings, I have my shutter speed to be 1/200, you know, my f-stop to be 4.0, and then you know, ISO to be 200. So, all right, okay, good. You can see the first shot from the camera. So guys, we are done here. So now we are moving straight to the Photoshop to do the final magic. Thank you.
So here we are in Photoshop. Let me zoom the product so that you can see very well. I'm using Photoshop 2025, with the one with AI beta. First thing we are going to do now is to, you know, select the background, right? So select subject, and when you select the subject, right, you will see that the automatic selection will not do it perfectly. So you have to zoom the product and select the other parts that are not being selected by the automatic selection. So please don't forget. So you have to select it manually the way you want it, right? So you can see now, that's what I'm doing now. I'm doing the selection now properly before go ahead to generate what we want to generate for the product, right? So after doing the selection, then just feather it like two, and after feathering, now go to window and go to contextual taskbar. That's what we'll be using to generate this video. We're going to generate our props now. So what I want to generate for this product is, you know, a photo of a marble, you know, countertop in a Nordic bedroom with plants in the background. You can see that's what I'm typing now. So after, you know, typing the text, you know, that's like you instructing the AI to help you generate this. You understand? So if you are generating something for a particular product, it is very necessary for you to make sure that, you know, what you are generating is in relation, something that is related to, you know, the product, because that's the beauty of it. You understand? So guys, if you are here to subscribe to this channel, go ahead and do so, please. And also give this video a thumbs up. Also turn on the notification button so that you don't miss out in any of the valuable content that will be, you know, dishing out on this channel every week. All right, so generating field is loading now. So the AI is trying to generate, you know, various, at first it's going to generate three props. You can see it here. You can see it here loading, right? So let's wait and see what the AI will generate. Wow, this is sweet. Now you can see now generated three different backgrounds. So it's now left for us to choose the one we want, right? So this is the first one. This is the second one. And this is the third one, right? So if you're not cool with these ones, right, you can generate more. You have that liberty of generating as many as you want, right? So now I want to generate more and see if you can, you know, get better ones than this, right? So it's generating, you can see. Guys, don't forget to give this video a thumbs up, please. You know, like the video, comment, and share with others as well, so that they can also benefit from this knowledge. Now you can see the ones that generated, and that separate, you know, three backgrounds, right? So you can see this one. This is beautiful. This is, I think I love this one. This is, it's simple and it's classic, right? So I'm going to look at which one we'll be going for. So I think I'll be going for this one right now. I'm going to mask it, you know, click on the mask to hide it. You know, Command I from the keyboard and hide the background, right? So pick my brush two, then opacity, let's say 70. I think 70 is okay. Yeah, 70 is okay. Yeah, 70 is okay. Then flow, I think 70, 72, it's okay. Good. Now your foreground is going to be on white. So now we are revealing the background, right? So make sure you take your time and do it perfectly. Yeah, take your time and do it gently and make sure you have a clean work. So start revealing the background, start revealing the background. So we need to hide it because, you know, when AI generated the background, so it covers a whole lot of, you know, the pictures, you understand. So it was not looking perfect. Though it was looking good, but it was not perfect. So, you know, we had to hide it and manually do it the way we want it, right? So, and that's what we are doing now. So take your time and do it very well. And one amazing thing, one crazy thing about this generative field is that AI will always generate whatever you ask it to generate for you, right? But it will not give you the way you want it. Do you understand? So after generating it for you, you have to manually do it yourself. And it's not looking like what we want. You can see before, after. Take your time and do it very well. Take your time and do it very well. Guys, if you are here to subscribe to this channel, I don't know what you are waiting for. Please do it, subscribe to this channel, give this video a thumbs up, turn on the notification button so that you don't miss out any of the, you know, valuable content that we're pushing out on this channel every week, right? So now we are done. So I want to zoom the picture and see some of the things that needs to be, you know, do away with. You can see I don't like this, so let it go. So guys, if you're here to have this feature, if you're here to pay for this Photoshop feature, I don't know what you are waiting for. Pay for this AI better, this AI generating fee, and start enjoying this level of manipulation even more than this one self. So I'll still do more videos on various background manipulations using AI and all of that. So guys, we are done. This is how I use AI to generate this background for this particular product after, you know, after shooting it in the studio. You can see. So we're going to save the product now. So if you watch the video to this very moment, I appreciate you so much. Thank you so much. We've come to the end of the video. So if you're here to subscribe to this channel, please do well. Go ahead and hit the subscribe button. Give the video a thumbs up, comment, and share with others as well. Thank you. Bye.